Good afternoon, folks. This is Fred Campos, owner of DFW Website Designers. I want to wish you a very happy Easter on this April 17, 2021. And this is episode number 371 of your three business tips at 3 o'clock in and around 3 minutes. Small business owners, solopreneurs, if you're just joining us today, we're talking about the semantics of actually making a sale for your small business. And we've divided it into three different sections, whether it be cultivated leads or whether it be qualified leads. And today we're going to talk about sales ready leads. We're going to break that down into having a smooth online presence, pricing options, and follow-up. Now, you could take these techniques. I call these three different funnels. You could stack them, but most of the time in my business, I own a web design business, I run across clients that are at three different levels. Either I am educating or poaching them to eventually become clients. That's what cultivating leads are. Or, you know, they kick the tires and fill out a form, and they might be mildly interested in your product, but they need more information. That's a qualified lead. And today we're going to talk about those that call you up and are ready to buy right then and there. They're still going to have a pipeline from which they go through. Business tip number one, if you have an online presence, which I think you should, and if you don't, call me about it, you've got to have a transaction that is very simple to use. Let's say you're in e-commerce and they want to buy your particular widget. They ought to be able to add it to the cart and pay for it very smoothly. The least amount of clicks possible, actually. The more clicks you go through, you lose about 50%. Make sure there isn't any hangups. Make sure your merchant works. Test it. You want to have the smoothest online presence and the most different ways possible for them to buy. A good example of that is Amazon.com. You'll notice that you could search for it. You could see it. That you could have associated products. There's like four or five different ways to buy the same thing. That's what I refer to as a smooth online presence. Business tip number two, when you get to this type of buyer, they're going to buy. So you just need to give them options. You know, is it going to be 100% down? Or is it going to be 50-50? Are there going to be payment arrangements? Customers bought this, also bought this. Do you want to have add-on products? You need to give them more and more different options. We'll talk tomorrow about closing techniques, but one of the things you have to do in this is you should have different pricing models. Because it's not a question of whether they'll buy, it's a question of whether they buy this package or this package. So you want to offer them different pricing options. Business tip number three, even though they get this for you, even though they tell you're going to buy, this type of sale needs to be immediately, you're going to give them a price. In my business, you give them a price and follow up with them, usually within minutes of the inquiry. And then you're going to want to follow up on them the next day or maybe later on that day, and then maybe 2 days later, 3 days later. These are really, really hot leads, and your ability to do follow-up is going to be paramount for your close ratio. Most of the time, what I see is customers do a really great job, but they really drop the ball on follow-up. When I really closed in follow-up, it really brought my close rate down up into 60, 70, 80%. So follow-up is extremely important. Just to review what we've talked about, smooth online, pricing options, and follow-up. That's what I'm learning today. Anything I learn, I throw over the fence to you because I want you guys to be awesome. Now go back to sleep.